Well, man, brother, pray out mightily like always. You know, all praises to Yahweh, Hashem El Shai. We're out here again on another Sabbath, you know, trying to wake up the people, whether they hear or forbear. That's all of the Most High, isn't it? You know, because you've got a lot of people walking up and down here that don't even believe in the Most High. You know, we've got some devilish sort of show going on down the road, bringing out all the Sonobites, all the Sodomites, all the faggots. Do you know what I mean? So we're out here to bring out the righteousness. You get me? So yeah, man, we're gonna go into some news, what's been happening in the last week, you know? So yeah, I'm gonna start on this one. Disney Plus, just a little one to throw out there. They're saying it broke their promise to stay family friendly, yeah, and adds R-rated movies. So basically, there was an agreement that they had to do everything that was child friendly, innit, because it was Disney. But they've already broke that now and they're starting to bring out other things. So if you let your children watch Disney and that, you know, be careful, because they might just fling an advert in or fling some recommended or something that's, do you get me, that's not edifying, but that's not worthy for a child to see, you know. So be careful. And we know about Walt Disney and his devices, do you know what I mean, that he brought out when he was, you know what I mean. But yeah, just that's a quick one on that. Do you got something for that? Yeah, come, bring that out, King.
This is the book of Nahum, chapter 3 and verse 4. Because the multitude of whoredom from the world favor harlots, the mistress of witchcraft, that selleth nations through her whoredom and the families through her witchcraft.
That's right, man. Beautiful, because that's what it is. It's all witchcraft, man.
That's right.
You know, all these new films that they bring out, that's all they're dealing with. They're dealing with witchcraft and necromancy and idolatry and all sorts of wizardry, you know? And that's how they're getting the children, man. So we need to know that what we're letting our children watch, you know? Because we have to be wary, because these are Esau's devices that he's going to use to turn out our children, man. Because, you know what I mean? That's what they've done.
Go on. This is the book of Numbers, chapter 23 and verse 23. Surely there is no enchantment against Jacob, neither is there any divination against Israel. According to this time, it shall be said, Jacob and of Israel, what has powers of what?
Yeah, come, man, and that's what I mean. If you're bringing your children up and your household in the law, statutes and commandments, there's none of these things are going to affect you. You know, no divination, none of Esau's witchcraft, wizardry will be able to affect you. But if you're not, then, you know, you're just open, man. The adversary's out there willing to eat you up. And he's gonna do everything that he can, you know. That's what Satan's job is to do, is to try and get you out any way he can, out of the spirit. And that's why we need to stay in these commandments, man. We need to read. We need to pray, fast, you know, we need to be that righteous vibration in these times, man, because there's so much wickedness in the earth. So yeah, man, the next one now is, what's it? Monkeys now. Monkeys are attacking people in the city of Yamaguchi in Japan. They're saying they're targeting young children, babies, old people. Yeah, and 58 people have been attacked. So now even the monkeys, now even the animals are starting to turn on these heathens. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they
like literally.
I see that one where they attacked the dog, innit?
Yeah.
I see one where they was grabbing the dog, man. And the guy, you know how they love their dogs as well. They came out and they tried to save the dog, man. But the people, like, the monkey was getting nuts. He was beating up the dog, and the people jumped off the ladder. They ran away. The children ran. But the mum came out to try and save the dog, bro. But the dog was already getting destroyed by the monkey, man.
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. Now they're actually attacking the people. You know, they're attacking the Ammonites. You know, and what they're saying is they're leaving out traps and that, like food traps, because they're going around trying to tranquilize them and put them down for what they're doing. they're leaving food out, and they don't even want the food. They just wanna put hands on these heathens. So all praises to Yahweh Bashim Yahushua. Give me a second Ezra chapter 5 and verse 8, Baba Kashar. Because yeah, that's what's gonna happen now. It's not just gonna be even at monkeys, it's gonna be beasts, four-legged beasts, it's gonna be lions, it's gonna be leopards. And wherever you are, it's going to be all manner of beasts that are going to turn on these people. And you too, Jake and Eve, if you don't repent, you know, that's why you need to stay in, like the brother just brought out. We want that shadow of Yahweh over us when these things come, you know. Because who ain't going to be scared of a lion that roars? You know what I'm saying?
Jacob, there is to elect.
Do you see what I'm saying? Exactly, because they know they got the Most High. That's why Daniel, he went into a lion's den with a hungry lion. You know, they even made sure they starved the lion. And he wasn't afraid, innit? Because he had faith, man.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? That's what this is all about. We need to have the faith. You know, you got that.
Lions don't eat lions, man.
Exactly.
And Daniel's the lion.
That's it. Come.
This is the book of 2 Ezra, chapter 5 and verse 8. There shall be a confusion also in many places.
What? Say that again.
There shall be a confusion also in many places.
Oh,
and the fire shall be sent out again. And the wild beasts shall change their places.
And the what?
And the wild beasts shall change their places. And menstruous women shall bring forth monsters.
And that's
what's going to happen in these. This is happening now, you know?
Yeah.
All these animals are starting to seek refuge in places that they're not actually used to. Do you know what I mean? Because the times are changing now.
Yeah, but they're hungry, man.
Yeah, exactly. And this is what I mean. These monkeys ain't even hungry. Sorry, sister. Yes.
Yahweh Shai.
Hey,
give me a 2nd Ezra 16.
So yeah, man. Eventually,
2nd Ezra 16 and 6.
Eventually, it's gonna be all sorts of. Because the thing is, these monkeys ain't even looking for food. They're looking to put their hands on the Abaddon. You get what I'm saying? That's real. That's, you know, and there's a picture of the monkey on the gates, like, because they got like gates on their windows, and it's just there like me mugging them.
And you get me? That's funny because Planet of the Apes, man.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
A rise up of the monkey.
Caesar and was it Cobra?
Yeah, Cobra.
Cobra
was writing Jacob on the blackboard, didn't it? So Cobra in monkey language just means Jacob, man.
Yeah.
Cobra. So Cobra, yeah, Jacob, man. And yeah, he's pissed off, man. Cobra was like, nah, I'm not trying to be friends with them, Caesar, man. Mm. I wanna pick up the thing and lang them up, man.
Yeah,
so the monkeys are a cobra
yeah,
spirit, man.
Yeah,
yeah, man. We got the cobra spirit on the monkeys, man.
Because you know, in that as well, he wanted to separate from the enemies.
Yeah. He didn't want to, you know,
help them to give them electricity.
Exactly, because they were speaking smooth words, and, you know. Listen, you can't make this up, man. Every movie, every series is always gonna show you the truth in some way about these Edomites.
Yeah, 2nd Ezra 16.
Go on.
The book of Daniel, chapter 7, 25. And he shall speak great words against the Most High, and shall wear out the saints of the Most High, and think to change times and laws.
We're talking about the beast up. About why the beast are going to destroy the people. Oh,
Go on. Sorry. And they shall be given into his hand until a period of time.
Times,
and dividing of times.
Yeah, come. Yeah, because that's going into the previous one as well about the Disney and that, you know, because they've broke what they've set a promise that they said they was going to do and not play our certain rated movies on Disney, which mostly the children watch. You get me? You got that?
Yeah. I got a book. Which one? 16 and 6.
May any man drive away a hungry. The book of 2nd Ezra, chapter 16 and verse 6.
Bring it out.
May any man drive away a hungry lion in the wood, or may anyone quench the fire in stubble when it has become to burn.
That's it, man, and that's what the Most High is saying here. Like, may any man drive away a hungry lion. No one can, really. If a lion wants to eat, he's gonna eat, innit? But that was the faith that Daniel had in the lion's den, that the Most High, you know, he shadowed him, innit? That faith he had in the Most High, he wasn't scared when he went in that lion's den, innit? Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you got one? Go on,
this is the book of the wisdom of Solomon, chapter 11 and verse 17.
Bring it out.
For thy almighty hand have made the world of matter without form, wanting not means to send among them a multitude of bears or furious lions, or unknown wild beasts.
Unknown wild beast,
full of rage.
Full of what?
Full of rage. And that's what these monkeys have, man. They have rage towards an Ammonite, the so-called Japanese. Go on, bring it out.
Full of rage,
newly created, breathing out either the fury of the fiery vapor of filthy scent of scattered smoke, or shooting horrible sparkles out of their eyes.
Nice.
And these things are, you know, these
spiritual powers.
Yeah, these are the newly created beasts that are gonna, do you know what I mean? That are gonna, and I'm sure it says in there, if you even look at them, you'll be terrified.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Just by the look of them.
Yeah, exactly.
This is Ecclesiasticus, Sirach, chapter 39 and 28. There be spirits that are created for vengeance, which in their fury lay on sore strokes in the time of destruction. They pour out their force and appease the wrath of him that made them. The Most High made everything.
That's right.
Fire and hell and famine and death, all these are created for vengeance. Yep. Teeth of wild beasts.
Teeth of what?
Teeth of wild beasts. Like cobra, like the cobra spirit monkeys,
yeah.
And scorpions, serpents, and the sword, punishing the wicked to destruction.
And so all these things are created from the Most High for vengeance. So this is what he's going to use to proclaim
the acceptable day of the Lord's vengeance.
Bro. Calm, that's it. Beautiful. Do you know, that's his vengeance, isn't it? That's how he's going to do his judgment. And the Ammonites, they're getting it out there, man. We'll hear probably more on that one still.
But, and the so-called Japanese people.
Yeah, the Japanese, in a city called, was it Yamaguchi? So yeah, look that one up.
The Yakuza clans. The Yakuza clans are getting monkeys.
So yeah, what's it?
The monkeys are pissed off, man.
Yeah, no, it is.
The monkeys are pissed off. You've been eating them too long in your damn Hong Kong styles, man. Or they eat the monkeys in the Yakuza style, man. Hong Kong is China, isn't it? So yeah, so yeah, these are Japan.
Tokyo.
Yeah, your Tokyo style monkey. Your monkey sweet and sour sushi style, man. The monkeys are upset and now they're eating you damn Japanese people, man. Even the monkeys are upset with you, man. That's why we need to study the bird, man.
That's what I'm saying. And all these things are of the scripture. This is all prophecy. So yeah, man. This is all of the Most High, man. This is prophecy. You know, these things, these beasts, everything is for the Most High's wrath. You know?
To appease the things that
we have. Yeah, exactly, man. And they don't transgress. They don't transgress his word. So yeah,
the US now accusing Putin, Vladimir Putin, of using food as a weapon after his forces attacked a key port that is used to ship desperately needed grain to the world. Oh, and we knew this.
They know. Yeah, we were saying, you've been saying this for months.
Yeah, months.
But we know that they got the grain, the most grain in the world. But now the other nations, they're realizing, wow, we're running out of bread supply and all of these things that feed their factories, right?
Yes, exactly.
But what he done, he signed a treaty, right, in the summit, right, the other day, like a week ago, to say that Ukraine and Russia, they proper sat down, bro, their ministers, bro, sat down and said, we will distribute grain. Understand?
Yeah.
And Russia and Ukraine was going to start distributing grain to the world again. Now, as soon as he signed it, wham! They sent a missile, bro, right on the docks. The same day they signed it, Ukraine tried to send the grain out. The same time, Russia was like, nah. They, remember, their covenant.
Yeah.
With oil, smoother than butter. But war is in their heart, bro.
That's right.
That Psalms 55 and 21 and 20, they come to fruition straight away.
Yeah, see?
Saying is they write covenants and they break them, man.
Straight away.
Straight away, bro. Yeah. Sent missiles to the docks and they tried to bring out the grain.
Yeah.
The whole grain factory in smoke.
And like you just said in the beginning, it's Ukraine and Russia, they actually distribute, like, I think it's like 60-70% of the world's grain, you know, like wheat and that, you know. So, you know, this port holds a lot of wheat because, remember, Russia's not dealing with the world now, you know, Ukraine is. But that's what I'm saying, Russia has basically taken over the port that Ukraine are using to distribute it to the other nations, you get it? So yeah, that's happening. You got one?
Yeah.
Alright, give me a second, Ezra 16 to 21. So yeah, this is what's happening, man. And look, as you can see, this crazy flipping, like the amount of bugged out people that man is seeing today is madness still. You know? Well, bring it out, King.
This is the book of 2 Ezra chapter 16 verse 21. Behold, victuals shall be good, cheap upon the earth.
Go on, say that again.
Behold, victuals shall be good and cheap upon the earth.
That's what it is now. You know, you can go in these shops, you can buy whatever you want. You know, all right, it's getting, the prices are going up a bit, but it's all there in abundance. You can pick and choose. Go on.
And they should think themselves to be in good case.
And that's what everyone feels, you know, they're in a good case, they've got their fridges are full up and that gone.
And even then shall evil grow upon the earth.
And so, what?
And even then shall evil grow upon the earth. Sword, famine and great confusion.
And that's what it is, man, great confusion, because when this all hits the fan, people ain't gonna know who's who. If you ain't been studying your Bible, if you ain't been listening to the prophets, you're not going to know who's your friend, who's your enemy, you know? So this is why we need to come back to these laws, man.
Great confusion.
That's mad.
As soon as you said that, look, the damn police cars there, look.
Yeah,
confusion, man.
It's crazy out here,
It's crazy. Confusion, man.
Look, that's exactly what it is.
Jake stumbling.
Confusion, man.
And look, Jake stumbling on the. You get me?
And one thing I'll notice quickly on a side note, out of all these people, it's very rare I've seen any Jakes or Eves going to this concert, which is a good thing. All praises to Yahweh Shem Yahushai. But this is the stuff that they're going to push onto our children. Children are going to see this stuff, man.
They'll do the little Uzi Verts.
Yeah, man.
They'll do the damn, what's his name, Little Nazis and... Mad.
Yeah, crazy, man. So, yeah, what's it, another one now, yeah? China's President Xi Jinping warned Joe Biden, saying, those who play with fire will get burned.
Woo!
During a two-hour call the other day, yeah, in the morning, because the tensions are rising over Taiwan and China. You get me? So basically China's actually kind of threatening Biden here now, saying, look, man, if you play with fire, you're going to get burned.
That's bad man talk.
And this is what's happening, because as soon as that's happened, yeah, US before, I think Nancy Pelosi, she went to do had a meeting, I think in Taiwan. I think it was Taiwan, I might be mistaken. But soon as they did that, a US aircraft carrier, strike group, moved into the South China Sea. So this is what I mean. China know what's going on. They're seeing all these moves that Esau's making, you know, and the Confederacy in Psalms 83 is gonna get broken soon. And that's what's happened, that's what the brother just brought up. Do you know what I mean? It's gonna be broken, man. So yeah, there's more. North Korean leader Kim Jong-un said his country is ready to mobilize its nuclear deterrent in any future military clash with the United States and South Korea. Yeah? So, you know, Kim Jong saying, look, we're ready to defend ourselves now against America and South Korea. And not just that, they've been doing military drills and testing nuclear weapons. I'm not sure, but they've been testing nuclear missiles in certain areas. What else as well? Washington and Seoul have repeatedly warned that Pyongyang is preparing to carry out its 7 nuclear tests, a move that the United States has warned will provoke a swift and forceful response. So Biden and the US are basically saying, if they keep doing that, or if they do this, their 7th one, then they're gonna do a swift and forceful response. So yeah, like, these nations are starting to go against each other now, man. Like, nation against nation, kingdom against kingdom. Yeah, go on, bring that out, King.
The book of Obadiah, chapter 1 and verse 7.
Yeah, go on.
All the men of your confederacy have brought you even to the border. The men that were at peace with you have deceived you,
good.
Have prevailed against you. They that eat your bread have laid a wound under you. There is no understanding in here.
That's right, man, and if that's what it's going to fall down to in the whole end, because remember, Esau, he is the one that's ruling. He is the one that has the ultimate say over these nations. The dollar is the one that's controlling the currency across the world, and it has been that for a while.
Now
that's going to be broken. That confederacy is going to be broken, you know? And these nations are rising up against each other now. The weak are saying, I'm strong, because back then, you know, it was always America that had the nuclear missiles and all the firepower, but now all these other nations have. Even Iran have now. They've got a missile city, you know? So yeah, it's getting peak. You got some?
I was just gonna add as well. Because now Russia and China have changed their currency.
Yeah.
The brothers didn't know that. They're taking away like the Russian money and the Chinese money, and they're now starting to use like natural minerals like gold, silver, zinc, copper. That's what they're gonna start trading and paying with now. And they cut off the Western society, and now just doing it between them. So they're saying they don't want no more with the dollar, so the dollar's going to lose its value, and they're going to start running things on gold, zinc.
Habakkuk 2 and 6.
Because what's that treaty is, isn't it? Because there's a thing between Russia and China and a couple other nations.
The BRICS.
Yeah, the BRICS.
It's, Iran, Brazil, South China, South Africa.
Yeah, so that's
Turkey are jumping in as well.
That's what the brother's just going into.
Gomar, isn't it?
Yeah.
Turkey's jumping in Ezekiel 38.
So that's what the brother was just saying about the currency, because when they do that, they make it, yes, King, you're right.
Yes, brother.
How you doing?
I'm all right, brother, man.
Yeah, that's good, man. Right. Much I'm love, just, man. Still.
What appreciation you guys got for today, man? What knowledge you got for today?
Well, we're just out here bringing out the news right about now, but basically we're out here to show the so-called blacks, Native Americans, some of the Indians,
that have been through these passes that the Bible prophesied that they're the Israelites of the Bible. And they need to keep the law, statutes and commandments. And then we'll be on high, man, because right now it's a, like the brother just brought out, it's gonna get peak on the earth, man. All sorts of famine, pestilence, wars about to kick off. Yep. This is what we're actually going into now.
But we're in the end times already.
Yeah, we've been in the end times, but the closer and closer it gets, yeah, the prophecies are playing out. You understand?
So that's right.
This is what it's all about, the prophecies in the Bible. That's why in 2 Ezra 9:1 it says, measure the time diligently in itself.
Yeah, read so, it, read it.
Yeah,
bring
it out. Bring it out. Because that's what we're doing. We're watching the signs of the times and we're matching it with the Bible.
Precepts, come.
Precept upon precept. Because, you know, not everyone understands this. People might read this as a normal book and not understand that this is actually a living book that we need to adhere to. Go on.
This is the book of 2 Ezra 9:1. He answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself. Yeah. And when thou seest part of the time past, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou know that it's the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made.
And that's what he's doing now, man. We're seeing all sorts of earthquakes. We're seeing all sorts of storms at alarming rates, which is what he uses to cause judgment on the earth.
Rabbi
Kusha. The earth is wicked.
Yeah, even sodomites are at an all-time rampant, man.
Yeah, man, look, man, there's this Gaga concerts going on.
Bro, did you see the Gaga concert? You didn't see the sodomization that was going on over there?
We've been seeing it all day. We don't have to go down there. We're seeing it all, and this is what we're against all that, innit? The Bible's against all that. These lot are all going to get punished. But, you know, right now it's all about trying to get ourselves
right, first, yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? Because we need to seek our own salvation, you know? And it's not for everyone. Where, what's your nationality?
I'm Congolese, man. I'm from the Bantu, bro.
Yeah, that's it, man. So you know that your people go back to Israel.
I know, bro, man. We're the original Israelites,
that's
man.
That's it, man.
The original 12 tribes. I know, man.
That's right, man. But this is the thing. It's all good saying we know, but we have to start living.
Yeah, you see the teachings, man. Yeah. The one at the Vine of Israel London is the one with the like, visa.
We have to start living like them Israelites now.
Come.
We have to come out of this world, King.
Peace and love, bro.
Yeah, much love.
Peace and love. Peace and love.
Shalom. So, yeah, it's good to know this. It's good to know this still, man. So, yeah, where was we? Yeah, go on.
This is the book of Matthew. Chapter 12 and verse 25.
What?
And Yahweh Shai knew their fool and said unto them, every kingdom divided against itself shall be brought to desolation.
Yeah.
And every city or house divided against itself shall not stand. And if Satan casts out Satan, he is divided against himself. How shall then his kingdom stand?
And that's it, man, isn't it? Because to us, the Most High used all these nations against us, isn't it, as his sword. So, to them, to us, they're all Satan, isn't it? So they're all casting at each other, and that's what's happening, isn't it? You know, they're all going against each other. Is there more?
Matthew chapter 24, verse 6. Ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. And see that ye be not troubled. For all these things must come to pass. But the end is not yet. For nation shall rise against nation.
Yeah.
And kingdom against kingdom.
Yeah.
And there shall be famines and pestilence and earthquakes in diverse places. All these are the beginning of sorrow.
That's right, man. And like the brother said, we've been in the end times. That's right. But each time these prophecies are coming to pass, it's just getting closer and closer to the time. Do you know what I mean? Because remember, as we brought out last week about
Ezra, flaming faggots, man.
Habakkuk chapter 2 and verse 2. Yahweh answered me and said, write these and write the vision and make it plain upon table that he may read of it. For the vision is yet to one appointed time, but the end shall speak. And not tarry.
And remember you said.
And not lie. Don't we tarry, wait for it.
There is a
flame. Because it shall surely come. It will not tarry. Verse 6.
Look, there is Jake. There is a Jake there.
Against
a
him.
Flaming Jake, bro.
And a taunting parable against him. And saying, Woe to them that increase that which is not his. How long? And to him that leadeth himself with thick clay.
Laddeth himself with thick clay.
They shall not rise up. Thou shalt not rise up suddenly that bite thee, and awake that vex thee, and thou shalt be for a booty unto him.
That's right, man. Yeah, because these nations.
Huh? Yeah. It says the weak shall say I am strong, and get me the Isaiah 14. Innit?
Yeah, man.
Let the weak say I am strong.
This is madness out here, man. Still, it's bad, man. It's really bad. But this is why we have to stay in the scripture, because it's showing us that this is what's going to happen. Wickedness is going to exceedingly pollute the earth, which it has. You know, so now we've got like faggots, we've got flipping sodomites, lesbians, all out here trying to flipping promote their nastiness, man. You know, and trying to show the kids as well, the children, you know. So yeah, go on, bring that, kid.
This is the book of Isaiah chapter 14 and verse 16. They that see thee narrowly look upon thee and consider thee, saying, is this the man that made the earth to tremble?
Is this what?
Is this the man that made the earth to tremble?
Yeah, because like I was saying, back in the day, it was US that had all this. It was the Edomites that took over America that had all the firepower. Even going before that, going back to the Roman days, man, and how they were in it. They were exceedingly strong, man, when they took over their kingdom. God.
And destroy the cities thereof that open not the house of the prison the house of the prisoners. All the kings of the nations, even all them, lie in glory. Everyone is on out his own house.
Yeah, man, and that's what I mean. They're the oppressors, man. Look at this. Get that on camera, man. Oh no, that is madness. Madness.
What the fuck are you doing? You're literally so stupid.
Okay.
You're literally preaching about something that doesn't exist.
Yeah, you're not gonna exist
eventually, man. Oh, a middle
finger.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah,
yes. Yeah, that's all good, though.
You got another one.
That's crazy. This is what I mean. When a child sees that, what are they thinking?
Crazy.
Yeah,
crazy.
Man.
Crazy.
You know? Look, this one's taking a child to it. Was I pointing at you? Are you a child?
Oh yeah, don't worry. Exactly. Shut up.
Yeah, look, that child there, look.
It's madness out here, man. It's madness out here, but people laugh at it, you know, and then these are the same people
that will say, oh look, they could do what they want as long as they don't bring that shit near me. Excuse my language.
And it's in the ghettos, man.
Yeah, but come on, bro. You're advocating for it. Still.
It's in Tottenham, bro. It's mad.
So, yeah, what's it? Sri Lanka's new president and one of the UK candidates, yeah, are part of the WEF program, yeah, whose agenda is all about this new world order and bringing in this RFI chip and all that, which is going to be the mark of the beast, which is going to happen. So, yeah. And Sri Lanka's economy's crashed, you know, so, you know, they've just put someone in power. I think Boris left, innit? So we ain't even got a prime minister right now, have we?
Yeah, I think he's done.
Yeah, yeah, so, you know, I couldn't give a damn about all this, but it does play a fact on what's actually going on, you get it? So we do need to kind of take heed of that, you get me? So, yeah, get me Psalms, innit? Psalms 83 and 3, man. Finish on 6, you know? Yeah, this is crazy out here, man. imagine what it's going to be like. Well, I don't even imagine, actually, still. But yeah, that concert, hopefully something like, you know, with that Ariana Grande thing happened before a bomb went off or something. So hopefully something like that goes off in the Hotspur.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 83 and verse 3.
Go on.
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people,
yeah,
and consulted against thy hidden ones.
Yeah.
They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation.
That's right.
For the name of Israel, Yasharela, may be no more in remembrance.
And that's all of them as well. That's not just one. It goes into all of them anyway. Go read.
For they have consulted together, and they have consulted together with one consent. They are confederate against thee.
You're right. So just like Russia is with China, you know, Taiwan is with US, Ukraine is with US. It's their whole main confederacy is to keep Israel from knowing who they are. Go on.
That's
the
right.
Tabernacle of Eden.
The tabernacles of what?
The tabernacles of Eden.
Go on.
And the Ishmaelite.
Yep, so we've got the so-called white man, we've got the Arab man, go on.
Of Moab.
Yeah, they've got the Chinese.
And the Hagarene.
And we've got the Africans, isn't it? And obviously there's many more, because what nation hasn't?
That's had right.
Part of our spoils.
Huh, teach
so, up. Yeah, this is what it is, man. So the judgment is coming, man. You know, you can go to these concerts all you want and party and be faggots and all that, but just know fire is going to rain down, yeah? Because when Putin's ready, he's going to press that button.
That's right.
Yeah, and if you're not covered by the shadow of the Almighty, Yahweh Bar Shem Yahushua, then you're going to get destroyed.
Teach up.
Yeah? Because that's what's happening, man. So look, come on. Judgment now, this is what they're saying, is judgment of God. Yeah, so because disaster after disaster keeps hitting the United States. So get me Psalms 9 and verse 16, because you know they're asking is it of the Most High?
They're asking for insurance policies, like, man. Like, can my insurance policies claim for this disaster, man?
Yeah, this fire or this flooding.
It's hazard, you get man. Me? And they're saying freak natures. They call it freak disasters, natural disasters,
yeah,
acts of God.
Yeah.
They don't have insurance.
Yeah, they don't have insurance for that, man. So,
yeah. Why? Because if it be of the will of the Most High, you cannot turn it back, man.
That's right. That's right.
You're going to get money back from the Most High saying he wants your team to burn up. Yeah, man.
And this is what they're saying, though. They're asking, is judgment of the Most High? That's what they're saying. Go on, read that. King.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 10.
Look, Jerry's Jake.
Verse 16.
Look, Jake's there. Look.
Yahweh is known by the judgment which by the judgment which he exalted.
Executed.
Which he executed.
Yeah, read that one again.
Psalm chapter 9 and verse 16. Yahweh is known by the judgment which he executed.
Say that again.
Yahweh is known by the judgment that he executed.
So this is how we know the Most High. When we see his judgment on this earth. So of course it's from Yahweh Bar Shem Yahushua, God.
The wicked is led in the works of his own hand.
That's right.
So I can run. He loves.
Yeah, and that's what it is. These wicked, these Esau, these Ammonites, these Moabites, all these other nations, they're snared in their own devices, man.
That's right.
They're going to think that they're controlling it. They're doing this. But really, it's all of the Most High, isn't it? And we know this, isn't it? You know? Because we it's plain to us, isn't it? That understanding, you know? We're trying our best to keep these commandments, isn't it? So we're going to see the judgments that the Most High ordained from the beginning. That is spoken through all these prophets. That he's going to bring and come
teach,
to
teach, Khan.
You know what I'm saying? You've got something else.
That's right.
Yeah, that was it on that, still.
I beautifully said, man.
Yeah? You've got something? All right, Khan. So, yeah, there's a major wildfire in California again, and we know there was loads of wildfires last week. Yeah? So what are you going to turn around and say? Someone did that. God, it was all of the Most High, man. You know, these wildfires, we just read it. Spirits created for vengeance. Fire, death, famine, all of these things are what created from the Most High, you know? There was more wildfires in South France, get me Baruch 6 and 63, I'm sure. more in South France. In Devon, UK, there was another wildfire, and it's been going on and off for about 2 months. You know, which no one really hears about it. They don't put it on the news and that like that. And like the brother was saying as well, these natural disasters that they call it, yeah, they're not insured for it. Fire, flooding, all of these things, earthquakes, none of these things that they get insurance for. So, you know, all these people are losing homes and that. So all praise to Yahweh Hashem El Shai.
That's right.
You know, because I've seen a picture before of some mad destruction, yeah, in America, a picture, yeah. It's like a hurricane went through a whole town. Everything was destroyed. I mean, everything.
Huh.
But there was one house straight, normal, like nothing touched it. Now, who was living in that house? That's what I want to know.
I want to know that.
Yeah, you get what I'm saying? Because it was someone who was keeping them commandments.
That's right.
Know that. Yeah?
Go on,
bring that, King.
This is the book of Baruch.
I need to get that picture, man.
And verse 63.
Go on, bring it out.
And the fire sent from above to consume hills and woods. Do as it commanded.
See? And that's what it's saying. It goes to the hills, it goes to the trees, and it does what is commanded. Yeah, the Most High commanded it, yeah, to do these things. Go on.
But these are like unto them, neither to show nor power.
Yeah, man, because, you know, the Edomites and all these other nations, they can say whatever they can, but they know deep down, well, no, they don't know, we know that they didn't cause these fires. These fires are on a different level now, you know, because when another thing, a fire is a cleansing agent, man. We bring this out all the time, you know. If a fire cleaned up a wild bit, just know it's going to grow back better next time. Yes, King. Yes. 2 minutes, man. 2 minutes. You'll find out who you are, you know.
Stop cameraing the damn drill artists, bro. They're killing each other, bro.
You're Israelite, yeah, of the Bible. You need to keep the commandments, yeah? And fear the Most High, because these lot ain't got no fear, man.
Nah.
That's why they reap, they add sin upon sin. Especially our people, you know, because judgment hasn't happened to them. You know, some of these other nations don't even have a conscience, man. They'll do wicked and evil things and not even feel like they're doing evil.
You saying? I think you're quoting Psalm 73 still.
Mm. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, we need to know, like, come on, when I was young, I always knew what was right and wrong, really. You know when you do something and you know it's wrong?
Call it conscience.
Yeah, conscience, man.
Guilty
that's
conscience.
That spirit. That's the Holy Spirit in some sense. Because you're not going to do mad wickedness and not feel no way about it. You're going to feel bad afterwards.
That's
you know
right.
What I'm saying? Yeah, what was that? 73, yeah?
Psalm 73, that's what you were saying, innit? Like,
okay.
Same thing you was kind of like paraphrasing.
Okay.
It's like they haven't felt the wrath, innit?
That's why they carry on doing what they're doing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, like, surely some of these, like, surely all of these faggots, before they became a faggot, they knew that it was wrong.
Ecclesiastes 8 and 8, huh? 8 and 11.
You understand?
Ecclesiastes, the preacher, 8 and 11 as well.
Innit? Before all of these lot actually became these sodomites and these faggots, they knew it was wrong. There was some fault in them, like, nah, it's not right to go with the same sex. So come on, innit? Unless the... Yeah, go on.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 66, and verse 16. For by fire and by his words will Yahweh plead with all flesh. And the slaying of the slave of Yahweh will be many.
Shall be many, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, 8 and 11.
Yeah, the fire shall be many,
man.
Yeah, man.
And, and Psalm 73, eh?
Remember, man, when the Most High brings his wrath, man, only a remnant are going to be saved, man. There's going to be great death, man, you know?
This is the preacher, Ecclesiastes chapter 8 and 11. Because sentence against an evil work is not executed speedily.
That's right.
Therefore, the heart of the Son of Man is fully set to do evil.
That's right, man. And these are the men. These are all these other nations, the children of men. You know, these lot are not the sons of God, man. That's why there's a difference, man. That's why not all can be saved. Like Mr. What was his name again?
Captain Saver Heaven.
Captain Saver Heaven, man. Like, not everyone can be saved, man. You know, because there's two lots, like you brought out. There's one for the righteous, the children of the Most High, and then there's one for the wicked and the evil, the children of men. Go on, you got that?
Bro, we're in the ghettos, bro. This doesn't even look like a ghetto no more, man. This was like Sodom, man. Sodom's gone crazy in the ghetto, man. You know the energy. Hey, bro, you need to stop smoking that reefer, man. Yeah, man, but it's all grown under madness, man. Yeah, but where'd you get the grabber from, man? Where's the grabber come from? Yeah, that even that is all madness, man. Haiti means hell's place, man. You ain't from the hell. You got Haiti. You got the grabber from hell. You got the grabber from hell, though, bro. Haiti means hell, man.
But listen, King. Where in the Bible does it say we can smoke? The herb was for our healing, isn't it? The herb was for the healing of the nation, wasn't it? So we don't meant to smoke it, man. That's defiling your temple, you know?
That's right.
If you like chop it up and put it in a tea and that, then yeah, we could get down, innit? Why not smoking, man?
You need to read the Bible and understand the Bible, okay?
Yeah, we
read the Bible, alright?
Yeah, we understand the Bible, man.
I've been reading the Bible since 1974, okay? Not yesterday. Some of you won't even fucking go on you.
I'll get that.
Alright, so read it then. Read it then. First
so
Corinthians.
Where does it say? Yeah, 1 Corinthians 3:16. Where does it say we can smoke it then? You know, if you read the Bible, let us know, man. We want to learn too, you know. We don't know everything, you know.
This is the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 16. Know ye not that ye are the temple of power, and that the spirit of power dwelleth in you?
Yes.
If any man defile the temple of power,
him shall the power destroy.
Man, so if we defile our temples, then the Most High is not working with us, innit? Straight up, innit? Because like Wisdom of Solomon 1:4, it says,
blessed love to the king and their mighty.
Yes. Hey, peace and love, bro. We love you, bro. Stop smoking, man.
Yeah. Peace and love, man. Telling the brother not to stop.
Hey, the sober one, Peter, innit?
Yeah, 5:8.
But the temple of power is holy, which temple ye are.
Yeah, man, so we're holy people, man. So we shouldn't be defiling our temple, man.
That's right.
Smoking, drinking. I mean, you can drink, innit? Moderately.
Moderately, yeah.
You get me?
Not,
you don't want to,
what,
like,
in the morning, waking up, yeah, brush your teeth and have a damn rare nephews.
Man. Yeah, man, because come on, wine was made for us, innit? We was made like, the grapes.
And what does it say? Wine is for the ones that want to put themselves to death, man.
Yeah, yeah, with a heavy heart.
A heavy heart, yeah.
Those that are ready to perish.
Proverbs 31, isn't it?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, read that, King.
Yeah, go on.
The book of 1 Peter, chapter 5, and verse 8.
Go on.
Right. Be sober. Be vigilant.
Be sober, be vigilant.
So we have to be sober and vigilant. Go on.
Because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walks about,
seeking whom he may devour.
That's right, man. So yeah, man. Like I was saying, all these other nations are going to be adversaries and devils, really, isn't it? Deceivers. So
roaring lions.
Yeah, man. So you don't. Yeah, exactly. And a lion, the lioness, and a lion. They don't haste, they're diligent with their prey.
They don't haste to come and find.
You get me? And not just that, they're smart with it as well. Like, they're looking at the pack, they're seeing who's the weak link, innit?
Yeah,
who's got a little limp or something.
And that's what I was saying about the damn the CCTVs and the way they use the Lila. The same thing, man.
Yeah, exactly.
That's about being sober and being awake, man. Separating from your enemies,
that's
man.
Right, man.
Can't.
Because obviously, smoking now is gonna have you, it's gonna be, you're gonna be all cloudy in that, man. You know, you're not gonna be able to think straight. I was there, man. You know, you smoke one, you're like this, like, come on, bruv.
serious.
Yeah, man.
You get the munchies. You get sleepy.
Yeah, man. Munchies.
If you don't feel those effects, it's not a good batch.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, like that.
Madness, man. That's why we need. That's a big stronghold on our people, man. The weed, man. We need to come out of that still, man.
And the excuse you ask, why do you smoke? I need to calm down. I got PTSD, or I mean, I got anxiety attacks, and they use some any excuses, man.
Yeah, but then these same, because I used to say that as well. Them same people, when they smoke a spliff and hit the road, they're like this. Like, they don't want to be around. No,
paro, man.
Yeah, do you get what I'm saying?
Turn schizo, bro.
But yeah, man. So yeah, what's it? There's been floods in Kentucky, Missouri, and St. Louis, Balochistan, Pakistan. There's been major flooding and mud flows, and in Sultanate, Oman. So there's been a few floodings around. Yeah, go on, bring that, King.
This is the book of Jeremiah. Chapter 46 and verse 8. Egypt rises up like a flood, and its waters are moved like the river. And he saith, I will go up and will cover the earth and will destroy the city and the inhabitants thereof.
Yeah, man. You know, that's it. So again, this is another spirit created from the Most High for vengeance, which is the waters, isn't it? When the waters overflows, you know, and it takes out flipping countries and cities and towns. You know, this is all of the Most High, man. That's why, you know, you need to get that shadow, that the law, statutes and commandments, which is that robe, isn't it?
The wing, yeah, man.
Yeah,
and
that
wing.
That's it. That's what I mean. The wing that shadows you in these times of affliction. Because that is an affliction too, man.
Isn't it? What is it? Psalms 23. I think you read us. Psalms 91. Or is it 27? Is it Psalms 27? One of those. Find it?
Yeah, man. So, yeah, the days are getting shorter as well, man. You know what I mean? I don't know, like, if anyone's feeling it the same, but all of a sudden, time's just gone, man. You don't even get a chance to do what you're trying to do. You know, you want to read, you want to study, and then next minute, time's just gone out the window, man. Yeah. So yeah, the days are getting shorter now, man. You know.
Is that it? Yeah, that's it. That's the beginning, yeah.
Yeah, you
wanna
bring that?
Yeah, he's got the funny one though, man, the Elohim and all that. Let's read it.
Read it, what one you want?
Psalms 91.
Yeah.
From one, isn't it?
The book of Psalms 91, verse 1. He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High God shall abide under the shadow of the Most High.
The Almighty.
That's it. That's it, man. The secret places in these scriptures, man. You know what I mean? Like it says, he that, what is it, get it, man? Sirach 39, of what? For sure. Yeah, 39 of what? Because, yeah, man, you know, this is the secret places. And these secrets, like the brother brought out earlier, they're not for everyone, innit? They're for Israel only, man. You know, so when we keep them book,
this is the book of Sirach, chapter 39 and verse 1.
That's right.
But he that gives his mind to the Lord of the Most High and occupies in the meditation thereof will seek out the wisdom of the ancient and be occupied in the prophecy.
That's right, man. So don't anyone in this truth, don't you want to be like the ancient, you know, like Daniel, Jeremiah, Ezekiel? Don't you want to be on that same vibration where you get visions and, do you know what I mean? You're keeping the law, statutes, and commandments. Because I'm sure that's what we all want, man. You know, we want to dwell in the secret places.
which is in these books, man, which is in the Genesis to Revelation, man. You know? And yeah, on one more now, there's a powerful earthquake, 7.1, that hit the Philippines, Dolores, and there was a 6.2 one in Chile as well, in Chile. So yeah, do you want to get me editions of Esther 11 and 5? I'm sure. So yeah, man, you know, floods, fire, earthquakes, do you know what I mean? All these things, man, we're not blind to the fact that it is the Most High judging, man. These things weren't happening at the rate that it was at it is now. Look at that, get that on the shirt. Buckle up, it's time to go to Babylon on his shirt. You get what I'm saying? So even these flipping subliminally, they know that this is Babylon, man. This is confusion, man. This whole society, this whole Western hemisphere, man.
Yeah. Revelations 18 and... Samson came by, man. Oh my gosh.
11 and 5.
This is the book of the rest of Esther, chapter 11 and verse 5. Behold, a night of a tumult with thunder and earthquake and vapors on the land.
Revelations 18
and uproars in the land.
Yeah, man. So this is what's going to happen. You know, certain places are having uproars with the people, like Sri Lanka still and that, because their economy crashed. Certain places in South America, like Venezuela and places like that, where their whole economy is just mashed up, man, because of Esau and his devices, man. Because, you know, he's just messed up the whole land. So yeah, man.
Is that the last one?
Yeah, that's the last one.
All right, yeah, man. Still, let's get out. Alright, yeah, you know the precepts, man. Let's get them. Let's get the precepts.
Alright.
Bring out. Revelations 18 and 3. 18,
verse 3.
Well, bring it out.
For all nations have drunk of the wine of the wrath of her fornication.
All nations have drunk of the wine of her fornication, man. Go on.
And the kings of the earth have committed fornication with her.
Alright, go on.
And the merchants of the earth are waxed rich through the abundance of her delicacies.
Yeah, everyone's waxed rich, man. All right, of Babylon. Go on.
And I heard a voice from heaven saying, come out of her,
do
my
what?
People.
Do what? Come out of her, my people. Right, you need to come out of Babylon, man. You're not meant to go back into Babylon, man.
That's right.
Babylon ain't got nothing for us.
That's right.
This world is destroyed, man. Sodomites are at all-time rampant in Tottenham, man. I've never seen so much sodomites ever, man. It's a damn shame. It's a damn shame, man. How the ghettos are now filled up with sodomites, man. But look, that's why it's gonna, the end days is happening, man. Read that again, come out.
And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people.
Yeah, that's what our whole message is saying, man. Awake, awake, man. It's high time to wake out of sleep, man. Salvation is nearer than we believe. Come out of this, my people. Alright, the Israelites, man.
That ye may be not partakers of her sins.
Alright.
And that ye receive not her plagues.
And that's what we've been saying. If your hand join in hand, you're going to be punished with her, man. Alright, all right, go on, bring out the precepts, bro.
This is the book of 2nd Ezra, chapter 16, and verse 66. What will ye do, or how will ye hide your sins before power and his angels? Behold, power himself is the judge.
The Most High is going to judge. You know, like, don't judge me, only God can judge me. But when judge judges you, bless you, sister, yeah? Peace and love. Keep the law, statutes, and commandments, right? But when God judges you, oh my gosh, what are you going to do then? That's when he's going to laugh at your calamities, man. Go on, bro.
Power himself is the judge. Fear him. Leave off from your sins and forget your iniquities. To meddle no more with them forever.
That's why we said the beginning, the first step is to fear the Most High, Yahweh. Alright, and stop sinning, man. Keep his law, statutes, and commandments. Go on, read, bro.
So shall power lead you forth and deliver you from all trouble.
And that's how you get delivered from the troubles, man. When you start to keep and learn his law, statutes, and his ways. Alright? Bring it up.
This is
the book of Psalms 132 verse 11. Yahweh has sworn in truth unto David. He will not turn from it.
The Most High has sworn the truth unto the tabernacle of David. Right? From Abraham to Isaac to Jacob. Huh? To the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. And the kingship shall not depart from Judah. Right? The conquering line of Judah. Man. Read book.
Of the fruit of thy body. When he sit upon thy throne.
Alright, from the fruit of his body, meaning the Messiah. He comes from the bloodline of righteous men. He don't come from this angelical damn Virgin Mary birth thing, man. He comes from Joseph. Man. Joseph is the seed line of Judah and David. Alright, read book.
If thy children will keep my covenant and my testimony.
If your children keep the testimony, the covenant, and remember, the testimony of the Messiah is the spirit of prophecy, man. That's why we read the news, man. That's why we go in the signs and the times of the what was going on, man. We have to be in the testimony of prophecy and seeing what's going on with today's lifestyle and events and mirror them with the prophecies of the Bible. Go on, bro.
That I shall teach them, their children also shall sit upon thy throne forevermore.
For how long?
Forevermore.
Yeah, forever, ever, man. Read that, Daniel 7, 18.
The book of Daniel, chapter 7, and verse 18. But the saints of the Most High God.
But the what? But the saints of the Most High God
shall take the kingdom.
Shall what?
Shall take the kingdom.
And what?
And possess the kingdom.
And they're going to... So what our premise is up here, yeah? Is that the saints of the Most High, go, get on the camera, because I think you must have to do something. The saints of the Most High, right, are going to take the kingdom, right, and possess the kingdom, right, you can pick it up,
I see.
But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom,
all right,
and possess the kingdom, go on, how long?
Forever.
For how long?
Forever.
So the saints, you believe the saints are going to take the kingdom? Do you believe that?
Yeah, if it's scripture, then yes.
Yeah, okay, that's right. All praises.
Who are the saints? Same time. Who are the saints?
Those who believe in Jesus, I'm guessing.
You're guessing?
No.
Go on, who are the saints?
You confess your mouth, Lord Jesus Christ. You'll be saved.
Well, who did he come for? Who did he come to save?
I think it's the first one says he came for the lost people of Israel.
Yeah.
But it's like Israel refused him. So on the cross,
where does it say that? Where does it say that he's not going to come for them anymore because they refused him? Where does it say that?
Well, the situation has changed. I remember John 3:16. Whosoever believes now.
Well, did you read the whole of John 3? You just went to verse 16. Did you read the whole chapter?
That's right.
The whole chapter before, yes.
Right, let's go to it.
Let's go.
You're saying John 3:16, right? That's what you're saying. Is that for whosoever believes is now for everybody in the world. Because the Israelite
believes.
Let me just care where you're coming from. Because we'll pack up and leave if we're wrong. Understand? And we won't come back out here ever again. You're saying because John 3:16 says, whosoever, right, he's not coming for the Israelites because they didn't obey. That's what you're saying?
I'm not saying he's not coming for the Israelites.
Whosoever is the whole world. That's what you're saying?
Yeah, because Paul is asking about Jews and Gentiles. There's no Jew.
Whosoever is for the whole world. That's what you're saying right now, right? Yeah, that's what you're saying.
Because of my understanding.
Okay, we're going to go to John. No, what you do? First of all, get me 2nd Ezra 14. We got this yesterday, right? 2nd Ezra 14. Do you know what 2nd Ezra is about?
That's a book of prayer, though.
Okay, all right. Yeah. So, did you read that?
I've touched on some of the books, but I'm not really into it.
Okay, but is this the word?
There's 66 books on the Bible, that's what.
Is this the word? It's Ezra in the Bible. The book of Ezra, is that in the Bible?
It's not the Bible that I read, anyway.
Yeah.
I know it's in some Bibles.
There's a book called Ezra, bro.
Ezra?
There's a book called Ezra, bro.
Okay, I thought it said Ezra.
This is another book of Ezra.
Yeah.
That's Ezra, and this is another book of Ezra, right? Yeah. It's just spelled different. What's that? Ezra 14. Alright?
She's on YouTube.
He's on us.
Yeah.
verse 33. Second Ezra's 2:33.
This is the book of Second Ezra, chapter 2 and verse 33.
You want to read that?
I, Ezra, received a charge of the Lord.
So Ezra received charge of the Lord. Like Ezekiel was told to go to the house of Israel. Isaiah was told, our people, they don't consider, they don't know. An ox knows his owner, us knows his master's crib. But Israel, they don't consider. We was but go to them. All the prophets were told to go to Israel. Do you understand that, right? Jonah was told to, he was a Hebrew, he was told to go to Israel.
Nineveh,
the Israelites in Nineveh. All the prophets go to Israelites, right? Go on.
Upon the mount of Obeah.
All right, Obeah, that's a place, right? You're told to go to the Israelites that were dwelling in that place. Go on.
That I should go to unto Israel.
All right.
But when I came unto them.
But when what?
But when I came unto them.
Go on.
They set me at naught.
They set me at naught.
And despised the commandments of the Lord.
And they despised the commandments of the Lord, all right? They didn't want to grow a beard. They wanted to eat pork. All right, and do the ways of the heathens, have birthday celebrations, heathenic customs. There's no, the Israelites' holy days don't have birthdays in them. Understand? Go on.
Verse 34. And therefore I said unto you, O ye heathen.
O ye what?
O ye heathen.
So the Most High said, go to the Israelites, and Ezra said, you guys, the Israelites, O ye heathens. Now another word for heathen is Gentiles. So Ezra said to the Israelites, oh,
so
it's
not like we are kind of Gentiles in a sense. You know,
they're acting like the heathens, so they've become Gentile minded. That's why we read Revelation 18 and 3, and it says, and 4, it says, I heard a voice, another voice saying, come out of her, my people. Meaning come out of that heathenic ways. Stop dealing with Father's Day and Mother's Day and Christmas Day and pagan days, man. Hold the holy, wicked days, man. Of the heathens, man. Now these are the paganism. That's paganism. Halloween, Easter, Christmas, Valentine's, Mother's Day, Father's Day, Thanksgiving, Bacchus worship, man.
Take pictures of some of this,
yeah, man. You need to learn, bro. Because you're going on with the doctrine of the Caucasians, man. No, you cannot talk. We are talking and our family, it's a family conversation.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You're not a part of the family.
I'm sorry, I didn't realize.
Yeah. It's our family conversation. You're being rude.
I'm sorry.
Right? You're butting into family conversation.
Yeah, I understand.
All right? So yeah, if these are our people, man. The ones that went into slavery by Caucasians, man. Mm. So these people are the ones he's saving. Understand? Because why? Now you're joining onto the heathens and acting heathenic, man. Nowhere has he said that he wants to join unto the heathens. He says, don't do the ways of the Gentiles. Don't do the cities of Samaritans. Don't go to their ways, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Right? Now Paul, same thing he done. He didn't go to the heathens. We're going to have to do it again. We've done it earlier, Romans 7:1. Oh, give me Romans 3 and let's get Romans 3:14.
This is the book of Romans.
Romans 3:14. Listen to this.
This is the book of Romans, chapter 2, verse 14. But when the Gentiles which have not the law.
So when the Gentiles which have not the law, meaning like the heathens, like Ezra said, they went away from the commandments, right? The same thing as Ezra said, right? Go on.
Do by nature the things contained in the law.
But they are naturally doing the laws. Go on.
These having not the laws are a law unto themselves.
Are a law unto themselves. They naturally do the laws. Who are the laws given to?
Moses gave the laws to the Israel.
Romans 9. At all the time. Romans 9. We'll read it again. In the New Testament. We're staying in the New Testament. We're going to read the Psalms as well. Psalms 149. To find out who the saints are. Alright, or Psalms 50 and 5. Yeah, it's on us.
No.
Forget that woman. We don't cast our pearls to the swine, man. Give not which is holy unto the dogs, man.
We follow, we are followers of Christ. We listen to what he says. Don't give which is holy. If they don't fit these conditions of woolly hair, burnt in a furnace. Do you understand what I'm saying, man? No, if the Messiah don't look like that. If anyone that come up looking like this vibration here, they need to jog on. Right, go on.
History has
not
worked.
No, he's in a stare, man. And he's not for everyone. Read this.
This is the
book of Romans.
This is the book of Romans, chapter 9 and verse 4. Who are Israelites?
Alright, go on.
Who pertaineth the adoption?
That's who Paul is going to. The Israelites. Who pertaineth the adoption? Go on.
And the glory. And the covenant.
And the glory and the covenants.
And the things given of the law.
And the, what, read that again.
And the giving of the law.
And the what?
And the giving of the law.
So the covenants, the giving of the law, everything was given unto the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
And the service of God.
And the service of God is only for the children of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. The so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
That's right.
And the promises.
And the what?
And the promises.
There's no promise for them. There's no promises for the Indians and the damn Japanese and the Chinese. There's nations in the world that's only coming to save the nations. Because there's gates in the kingdom of heaven, right? Paul is not going to ever say that I'm not going to the Israelites, my dad. Acts, give me Acts 26.
Paul, this was unique because he had to go to the Gentiles.
All of Paul is all about the Corinth. Where is Corinth, the Gentiles?
But Corinth is, he went to Rome and all.
Yeah, so Corinth is the way the Gentiles are, right? Then, isn't it? Yeah, but we've got to read Corinthians 10. 1 Corinthians 10. We're going to read this, 10 and 6. Read this, listen, read this.
This is the book of Acts, chapter 26 and verse 6. And now I stand and I am judged for the hope of the promise made of God unto our fathers.
And the promise is for who? You just read it. Who's the promise for? The promise is the giving of the law. Who's that for? Who are? You read it. Romans 9. Are you focusing, bro?
Okay, let me focus.
Who are Israelites? Who pertain to the adoption, the covenant, the giving of the law, the promises? All right, go on. So look, so the promises are brought unto our fathers, go on.
Unto which promise our 12 tribes.
Our who?
Our 12 tribes.
The promises for who? Of Israel.
Okay, instantly serving power day and night.
Right.
Hope to come. For which hope sake, King Agrippa, I am accused of the Jews.
He only got persecuted for the Israelites.
That's right.
Do you understand? Romans 9 said it, right? Mm. I wish myself was accursed from Christ
for my brethren.
My
kinsmen.
He never got accused for anyone else but the Israelites.
Ignore me, how can I learn?
Revelations. Oh, wait, focus. Revelations 21 and 12. Revelations is the last book of the Bible, right?
That's nice.
It's easy to understand, my guy. We're going to go John 3:16 to give you understanding. Go on. Read. Anyone read?
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 21 and verse 12.
Read, bro.
And had a wall great and high.
So there's a kingdom of heaven. And there's a wall great and high in the kingdom of heaven, right?
And had 12 gates.
And there's how many gates?
And had 12 gates.
There's gates for the Gentiles.
And had 12 gates.
There's gates for the damn Ethiopians.
And had 12 gates.
There's only 12 gates.
And at the gates, 12 angels.
And there's bouncers with lists. Like the guest list. Or the VIP list. The very important chosen people list. Go on.
And the names written thereon.
And the names written thereon.
Which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel.
The children of Ethiopia.
The children of Israel.
The children of Egypt. The children of Israel.
The children of Mitzrayim.
The children of Israel.
Children of Edomites getting into the kingdom. Do you understand? That's Revelation, my guy. That's like the last book. Like you've heard the whole conclusion of the book. You get to the last part, the final chapter, and we're closing up now, and it says there's only a kingdom for Israel.
Those who don't receive the mark of the beast.
So show me now where it says whosoever. Give me Acts 3. Before we even get to whosoever, we're going to chop that into pieces, man. You good, King, yeah? Give me Acts chapter 2 and verse 19. Before we even
bring it
get
out.
To
bring it out.
Whosoever, we're going to chop this down. And then when we read it, you're going to have clarity when you read it. Go on. 21.
The book of Acts, chapter 2 and verse 21.
Bring it out.
And it shall come to pass.
All right, this shall come to pass, meaning that, what does that mean? I've been asking that a lot. It shall come to pass. What does that mean?
Prophecy will be fulfilled.
That's right. Future prophecy. Go on.
That whosoever shall call on the name of the Most High.
Oh, wait. What did it say? That who?
That whosoever shall call upon the name of the Most High.
All right, go on. Shall be what?
Shall be saved.
All right, who's he talking to?
Ye men of Israel.
Who's he talking to?
Ye men of Israel.
Hear these words. Is he talking to everybody?
The people of Israel.
So whosoever are who? Who's he talking to? Ye men of who? Whosoever means the men of Israel. Hear
that's right. Word. That's right.
Sweating, bro. Your nose is getting a bit sweaty. Oh, bro, it's
close.
No,
no, it's humid. I'm not
all right. Right. Okay.
Not because of this.
Okay.
Joel, chapter 2, verse 32.
27. Okay.
And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel.
He's in the midst of who?
I am in the midst of Israel.
He's only the Lord God of Israel. Alright?
And I am the most high God and none else.
And he is the Lord our God, he's Yahweh, our power, and none else.
And my people.
Book of Joel, chapter 2, and verse 32. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered, for in most Mount Zion and in Jerusalem shall be delivered.
For in Mount Zion and Jerusalem.
That's not the whole world, my guy. Alright. So that Acts chapter 2 is prophesying Joel. He's gone, you have to read the Old Testament. Paul didn't have a New Testament in his hand. You understand? When he was prophesying, they were prophesying the Old Testament, telling them the Messiah has come and risen. Everything that we've been waiting for in the prophecies for the Messiah to come is come. You understand? And they're witnesses for him. The disciples were witnesses for the Messiah to go and preach to the people. Now what it is, we had Gentiles, minded Israelites, living, give me James chapter 1. We had Gentile Israelites living among the heathen, bro.
This is the book of James chapter 1 and verse 1. James, a servant of power and of the Master Yahweh Shai Mashiach, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad.
To the what?
To the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad.
So James knew to greet the 12 tribes that are scattered abroad. Oh yeah, greetings, man. Shalom, man. Shalom. Peace to the brothers. Yeah, man. In the winds, man. Right, onto the highways and the ones that are ministering this world.
I want to touch on them. Touching John 3:16. I want to touch on what your background, what your
James. No, John 3:16. James 3:16. Give me and John 3:16. And I want you to get. Give me Luke. John 1. John 1:47, and give me Romans chapter 11. Bring this up, bring that Romans 11.
Is it 11 and
1?
What?
Yeah, go on.
I say then, as the Most High cast away his people.
Alright, as the Most High cast away his people. Alright, go on.
Never!
God forbid.
For I also am an Israelite.
Because we are
of the seed of Abraham.
Because Paul is an Israelite. Go on.
Of the tribe of Benjamin.
From the tribe of Benjamin. Paul knows he's an Israelite. So he's not calling himself a damn Christian. He's not calling himself a Methodist. He's not calling himself a Baptist. He's not calling himself a Catholic. He didn't call himself a Christian. He never called himself a Pentecostal. He didn't call himself a Jehovah Wickedness. He didn't call himself a Seventh-day Adventist. He called himself an Israelite. Hey sister, I know you can hear this. Sister, you're an Israelite, okay? God loves you, right? You're the best. right? You're better than all the other dirty gal them on the roads. Alright, your nation, our nation, our women are the most beautiful, okay?
That's right.
No, there's no need for reading. Alright, give me the album. John.
This is the book of John, chapter 1 and verse 47. Yahushua of Nazareth coming to him and saying to him, behold, an Israelite indeed.
A what?
An Israelite indeed.
A Christian.
An Israelite indeed.
A damn Baptist.
An Israelite indeed.
Yeah, man, a Mormon.
An Israelite indeed.
Bro, he's an Israelite indeed, man. So when you see us, bro, you say, what are we? We are Israelites indeed. Just go over that side, man. Hey, move your team,
you could have went that way.
Move your team, man. Hey, keep going, man. Hey, yo, get this. Just go. An Israelite indeed, all right? That's who we are. Israelites indeed, followers of the Messiah, all right? That's what he wants to call us. He don't want to call us no damn bywords, man. All right, go on, go to John 3 and go to verse 1.
This is the book of John, chapter 3 and verse 1.
All right, read.
There was a man of the Philistines named...
Of the Pharisees
named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews.
All right, a ruler of the Jews.
The same came to Yahushua by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher come from power, for no man can do these miracles that thou didst.
So yeah, man. So look, Nicodemus, you're talking to this house, and these people are talking to you. He's not talking to the whole damn house. He's not talking to the damn Greeks. He's talking to the ruler of the Jews, my guy. Do you understand? All right, hold on to that message from verse 1 and 2. Go to verse 14.
That's right.
Now we've got the understanding of verse 1. Who he's speaking to.
Mm.
If I'm saying, yo, we're going to win this game today, and we're in Tottenham, am I talking to us? We're talking to the people that are Tottenham, saying we're going to win. All right? Go on.
John 3:14. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness.
Numbers 21:9.
Even so must the Son of Man be lifted up.
So Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness for who? Because this is quoting the Old Testament. Like I said, the Messiah is not going to be reading the New Testament to the people, to Nicodemus, to the ruler of the Jews. Is he? Come on. He's going to be reading what? The Old Testament, right? All right. Come on, let's focus, man. We've got 66 books now, but they had more than that back then.
Yeah. Some other books that are mentioned.
Yeah, they mentioned, yeah. That Jubilee, Jasher. All right. We're going to read the book of Numbers by Moses, right? Numbers 21.
The book of Numbers, chapter 21 and verse 9.
And all praises to the Most High. The book he quoted, we've got that. Mm. They didn't hide that. All right, we've got the first 5 books. All right, let's read.
And Moses made a serpent of brass and put it on a pole. All
right.
And it came to pass that if a serpent had bitten any man, when he beheld the serpent
he lived. Go on.
And the children of Israel set forward and pitched in Ophrah.
I mean, wait, who's this? I know who.
And the children of Israel stepped forward and pitched in Ophrah.
Yeah, so that's the children of Israel. So, who was the serpent in the wilderness with Moses lifted up for?
As long as the serpent was lifted.
Yeah, for who? Was Ethiopians there?
Israel,
was Chinese people there?
Israel,
was Indian people there?
That's right.
Come on.
So we're getting somewhere. We're actually breaking barriers, man.
That's right.
All praises to Yahweh.
That's right. All praises to Yahweh.
Come, you're listening. You need to come. Come, sister. We love you. Come. We'll watch the bus for you.
All praises. What's wrong with the name Christian? What's wrong with that name?
The name Christian is a byword, alright? It means it was a negative, derogative word for the children of Israel that I was following the Messiah. What were you waiting for?
Two 479.
Alright, let me see it, we'll look out. Alright, so yeah, it was a derogative word. You mean, yeah, so keep reading, both verse 16. Isaiah 45, 17.
This is the book of John, chapter 3, verse 16.
This is a big barrier on our people. They love to read this verse, right? Go on, read it.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believed in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
Whosoever, they think that the whole world now can be saved. Because anyone can call. You could take the mark of the beast and call upon the name of the Messiah. You're going to be saved? That's whosoever. So that's a bit of a contradiction. Understand? A faggot can walk around being lesbos and that. They can call upon the name of the Most High, right? Say, oh, Jesus Christ, save me. Are they going to be saved doing that madness? They shall not inherit the kingdom. That are fornicators.
Did you say 243?
No, 279.
Okay, correct.
All right, fornicators, adulterers, effeminates, they shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Fatty boys, sodomites cannot inherit the kingdom of God. So that whosoever, it's a bit shaky. You understand? We got to now find out how you enter into the kingdom of God. Right? Give me,
Isaiah,
yeah.
Chapter 45 and 17.
Revelations 14 and 12.
But Israel shall be saved.
But who?
But Israel shall be saved.
Yahweh with an everlasting salvation.
All right, there's the everlasting, man. Go on.
Ye shall not be ashamed or convulted. World without end.
What are they?
World without end.
That's the world there you're looking for. Because the scripture says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in them. When you go to John, chapter 1 John chapter 2 and verse 15.
That's right.
So what world are we talking about?
That's right.
There's three different connotations of the name world in different etymologies of the word. The world can mean cosmos, paphros, and... and another one. There's different meanings of the name world. So one can mean this is a man's world, this is the sea world, it's a woman's world, the animal kingdom, animal world. Alright, there's different worlds. But then there's also a world meaning the planet. And that word, that name, love not the world, meaning love not this planet. So there's different breakdowns of the name world. We're gonna show you now Revelations. Right? So Isaiah is telling us these men of the Israelites are a world without end. Right? This is an Israelite world that we live in. Right? This is a man's world. This is the Israelite world that the Most High says, whosoever of the Israelites can call upon the name. But Revelation 14 and 12. But this is what the Israelites have to do.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 14, verse 12. Here are the patience of the saints.
There's the patience of the saints. Give me the saints. Who are the saints? Saints are ain't little babies in damn nappies with wings. That's not the saints.
That keep the commandments of God.
They that keep the commandments of the Most High.
And the faith of Yahweh Shai.
And they have to have faith in the Messiah as well. No one is saying, we got the commandments and we're not faithful. We have to be faithful and keep commandments at the same time. All right?
The book of Psalms, chapter 50, verse 5. Gather my saints together.
All right, gather the saints together. All right, go on.
Those that have made a covenant with me by sacrifice.
That have been what?
That made a covenant with me by sacrifice.
And when we read Romans, who is the covenant? Who has the promises, the covenant, the giving of the law? The Israelites have the covenant, the promises, and the giving of the law. Who are the Israelites now? That's the biggest question now. Now we've gone over all of that. We need to identify, how are we the Israelites, right?
Who was first named Israel?
We're gonna show you. Jacob was named Israel, and his children are called the Israelites. They have his last name.
That's right.
All right. So now we're gonna show you why we are the Israelites. All right. John 7:49. Deuteronomy 28 and 45. John 7:49. All right. Yeah, John 7:49.
The book of John, chapter 7, verse 49. But his people who knows not the law are cursed.
But this people that know not the law are cursed. Alright? And what you got there, you got some of the book of Deuteronomy, some of the curses. We're gonna go through them. Alright, go on, read that.
This is the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 45.
Bring it out.
Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee and pursue thee and overtake thee till thou be destroyed, because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Old English, hearken. We didn't listen to the laws of the Lord Yahweh. All right.
Go on. To keep his commandment and his statute which he commanded thee.
All right. So that's what it says. We have to have faith in the Messiah and keep his commandments. That's the saints. And the saints have made a covenant, the Israelites. All right. Go on.
And they shall be upon thee for a sign.
All right. And if you get curses on you, and they're going to be a sign. All right. Like a sign. Like this is the Lady Gaga concert. This concert's the sign saying that way to the concert. That's a sign for the concert. Now this is a sign. We're gonna see if it marries up with them damn, them wickedness, them Ishi people, them Israelis and the Jewish people. Well, they're going to Sodom. We're going to Sodom, right? I go.
And for a wonder, and upon thy seed forever.
So these curses are upon us, and it said that if yet this day there are, the Jews are accursed. I'm gonna find out the conditions of the curse. Go 54.
Verse 54. Deuteronomy 28, verse 54. So the man that is tender among you and very delicate.
The man that is tender among you and very delicate.
His eyes shall be evil towards his brother.
Alright, black on black crime. Alright, Israelite versus Israelite crime. All the countries, man. JLP, PNP in Jamaica, Johnson's and the Burgers in Birmingham. You got Tottenham versus Edmonton and Hackney. Back in the days, like the TMD versus North stuff, versus damn Murder Mile and Hackney stuff, the Mash Town. We always have them things, but it's just now the younger generation are keep pushing that same curses that are on the nation, man. Bandana versus another bandana. All right, go on.
These eyes shall be evil towards his brother.
These eyes shall be evil towards his brother. Go on.
And towards the wife of his bosom.
And toward domestics in the household, man. We are the ones that are fooled up with domestics. You got brothers in Brixton, yeah, you have a messenger.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, all praises, good. Man. Shalom, sister.
Yeah? Love. All right, we'll pray for you, sister, okay? Yeah, man. Chastise her, but she's coming, man. In the affliction, there was
that's right. God.
And towards the raiments of his children, which he shall leave.
Single parent households in the yards, man. Back in the days, that was all about better equality for the households. But now we got the remnant of the children which are left. Why? Because the mums are now kicking out the dads, and because what? The system has given them a bigger pot to piss in. So, yeah, they're taking the piss. Mm-hmm. They got so a bigger pot to piss in, so the women and amongst our nation are taking the piss, man, right? This is a curse on the Israelites. Single parent household, black and black crime. Go to the Haman.
Haman. Deuteronomy 28 and verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
Now we went into Egypt, how? We walked into Egypt. We didn't go into ships. Jacob never brought his children into Egypt with ships. Alright? Go on.
By the way whereof I speak unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again.
Alright, that's our homeland, Jerusalem. Go on.
There you shall be sold to your unto your enemies.
You shall be sold unto your enemies.
For bondmen and bondwomen.
For bondmen and bondwomen.
And no man shall buy you.
No man's gonna buy you. Go on. Yeah. So who are been sold into our enemies? Bondmen, bondwomen. Serving wood and stone. I go to that. Go to 64.
Deuteronomy 28 and verse 64. And the Lord shall scatter thee among the people, all the people.
So who are scattered amongst all the people? James chapter 1 says the 12 tribes that are scattered abroad, the Israelites. Go on.
Among all the people, from one end of the earth unto the other.
And now they've taken on the customs of the heathen. What they was told not to do. If you see the manner of the gods, don't do that. Alright, go on.
And then thou shalt serve other gods, which neither thou nor thy fathers have known, even wood and stone.
And that's what we serve. We serve the carver stone, and we serve the damn, the cross. Which is a damn torturing technique for the damn lynching of the damn Ku Klux Klan. And the Romans, man. They hanged us on crosses, hanged us on trees. That's the Caucasians, and you wanna what? Be friends with them, and give them an inheritance. Give them a promise, give them a blessing. You're giving away your blessing of righteousness to the ones that have been killing us in the streets for how many years, man? It don't belong to them. They have not been promised that. It's only the promise of the Israelites, man. They are Edomites. They are called Esau. The who God hates. Does God not? Does God love them?
But it's all right.
Bro, I don't know, man. You know the scriptures, but it's like, what's her? Now I need to ask you a question. Why are you trying to be super saver here?
I'm not super saver, just, the way I come from, I concentrate me on the words of Christ. Yeah. She came from children of Israel, 100%. There's a story like the woman tried to receive the blessing. He said, no, I cannot give up to the dogs. I'm coming with the verse 15.
Matthew 15. Yeah, but go on. So, did she get a blessing?
I couldn't have faith. Like,
the point of the matter is, did she get a blessing?
According to her faith.
Did she get a blessing? No. Answer the question.
According to her faith, yeah.
Yes, you said.
According to her faith.
All right, we're going to find out. Okay. You don't know.
Yeah.
You don't know. Just say, I don't know.
According to her faith, you're healed.
Because you didn't read it properly.
Yeah.
You didn't read it properly, bro. If you read it properly, you'll find out the truth. Mm. We're going to read the truth.
This is the book of Matthew, chapter 15, verse 21.
No, start at 24.
Start at 24.
Verse 24. But he answered and said, I am not sent, but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
All right, go on.
Then came she and worshipped him, saying, Master, help me.
And we were talking about that. How do they get righteousness? By cleaving unto Jacob. All right? And they have to drag onto our skirt all languages. That's their salvation, by obeying. All right, go on.
But he answered and said, it is not meet to take from the children's bread and to cast it to dogs. And she said, true, Master. Yea, yet the dog eat the crumbs which fall from the master's table.
Go on.
Then Yahushua answered and said unto her, O woman, great is thy faith. Be it unto thee even as thou wilt. And her daughter.
And who?
And her daughter
was made whole.
So was she
from that very hour?
Did she get any blessing?
Well, she came in with her daughter.
Did she get any blessing?
Yeah.
Did she get?
No. She got what she wanted. She got what she wanted. And her daughter to be healed.
Like. She got what she wanted.
Yeah.
But what she wanted wasn't for her. It was for her daughter.
That's right.
Now can
but
we?
But she had to apply the faith.
Yeah, the faith that she knows she has to beg for, like a dog. Didn't she? She wasn't an Israelite, was she? But she begged like a dog, right? Like a dog begs at the master's table, right? And who was saved? Who got blessed? And so now, what I'm saying is, can a heathen woman, can a so-called white woman, come up to us and beg for us to pray for her daughter? All right? Yeah, she can, right? But we're not going to pray for that daughter unless her father is an Israelite, because it's through the seed line of men. Give me Numbers 1 and 13 and 18.
This is the book of Numbers.
We're not going to pray for that damn wicked heathen, man. We're not praying for none of the heathens, bro. We're not, no peace unto the wicked. All the heathens are wicked. There's no righteous spirit inside them. Alright?
No one is righteous.
Yeah, there is righteous people. Israelites are righteous people. Give me Psalms 53 and 1.
This is the book of Numbers, chapter 1 and verse 18. And they assembled all the congregation together on the first day of the second month. And they declared their pedigrees after the family by the house of their fathers.
By who?
By the house of their fathers.
So because of your father, all right, you will be considered as the wheat. There's tares among the wheat. The enemy have laid down with our women. That is why there's tears. But if the father has laid down with a heathen, that child still belongs unto the children of Israel. Hence, Ephraim and Manasseh, Joseph's children. Their mother is an Egyptian. Moses, Zipporah. Moses has got children. that is still a Levite child. But the mother is an Ethiopian, right? So yeah, that doesn't mean, but his wife is an Ethiopian.
Okay, you don't know, yeah.
Numbers 12, go to Numbers 12. And it says,
This is the book of Numbers, chapter 12 and verse 1. And Miriam and Aaron spake against Moses because of the Ethiopian woman.
Because of what?
Because of the Ethiopian woman.
So yeah, they spoke against the Moses, man. And the wicked, they're not allowed to touch them in our Bible, bro. The Bible's not for them, bro. So there's no Captain Save a Heathen, bro. Right? Yeah, Psalm 58 and go to verse 3, yeah. Yeah, that's it. Oh, read that.
Yeah. The book of Psalms.
Psalm 58.
Chapter 58 and verse 3. The wicked are estranged
from the womb. The wicked are estranged from the womb.
So it's like as soon as they come out of the womb, they're wicked. They're exchanged, man. They're disgusting. They're vile. There's no saving them.
They go astray as soon as they are born, speaking lies.
What do they do?
They go astray as
soon as they be born, speaking lies.
Like this Caesar Borgia, man. This Caesar Borgia is lies, man. As soon as they are born, they lie, they pillage, they kill, they steal, they build towns with blood. Right, read that.
50 and 3.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Psalms
13
and 16.
Oh, 16.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 50 and verse 16. But unto the wicked, thou sayest, What hast thou to do to declare my statutes?
But the Most High says these people are wicked, man. They're exchanged from the womb. They don't have nothing to do to declare the statutes or hold the prophets or hold the holy book.
Oh, that thou shouldest take my covenant in thy mouth.
They can't even talk about having a covenant in their mouth. Understand? Only the new covenant is only with the house of Israel and the house of Judah.
Good.
Right? So, bro, I hope any other questions, bro? Because we're trying to close up. As in the days of Noah. Matthew 24.
Before the flood, men was into wickedness, all sorts.
Yeah, the same thing we see today.
Yeah.
And Noah was chose why? Because he was righteous. Because he is righteous.
This is the book of Matthew, chapter 24, verse 36. But of that day and that hour knoweth no man, no, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only. But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be.
Right, as in the days of Noah, the coming of the Son of Man is here. Right?
But as in the day that were before the flood, where they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until Noah entered the ark. And knew not until the flood came.
They're not gonna know, man. That's what he's saying, yeah? You got brothers back.
Acts 13:26. Men and brethren, children of the stock of Abraham.
Children of who?
Children of the stock of
Abraham.
And whosoever among you who fears God, to you is the word of this salvation sent.
That's a cut. Whosoever, the stock of Abraham, bro. So now Abraham, who else was around, man? You got the Cushites, they're not the stock of Abraham. Right? Even Ishmael and Esau, they are the stock of Abraham, but they still don't have the covenant. Who are Israelites, who pertain to the adoption, the covenant, the giving of the Lord, and promises. Come on, bro.
Under Abraham, Isaac, Jacob,
and the children of Israel. Yeah. Right, there's no Captain Save a Heathen. They're done, man. Coons are done out here, man. No coons allowed in the kingdom.
Fuck off.
All right. See, and that's what's happened to our people, man. Our people, our women, are dogging the men, man.
She just slapped the guy, man.
See?
She just slapped the guy, man.
Out of all these people that have come past today, it would have to be our people that have done this again.
I'm saying that
of all the people that have gone past all today, like, you know, thousands, it would have to be our people to do that, cause a scene, you know? Obviously, that's domestics, what we just brought out in Deuteronomy 28 and 54. Do you know what I'm saying?
Hey, yo, sister. Hey, sister. Don't show up your king on the high roads like that. Hey, sister, don't show up your king on the high road like that. Don't show him up on the high road so all these damn Caucasian people are laughing at us, man. We need order in the house, man. That's your husband, man. That's your man. You're gonna now slap him in the face in front of all the damn white boys, man. Yeah, hey, yo, bro. Yo, bro, don't do that to your sister, man. Hey, bro. Hey, bro, take your woman and just go talk to her. Take your woman, man. Yeah, man. You're a king, bro. Don't touch her. Don't hit your woman, man. Hey, look, look, you see? You're going mad, bro. Yeah, man, look, look, he's fighting the wall, man. He's kicking things, man. And these heathens here, you can't save us. There's nothing you can do to help us. You're the reason why we're in this condition, man.
That's right.
Women like you, man. Look, because you're damn lesbos, man. Lesbos ain't saving our straight lives, man. All right? Anyway, straight pride, man. How can gay pride help straight pride, man? That don't mix. All right, go on. Straight pride, all right, don't need help from the gay pride, man. Gay pride, do your thing and leave the straight people to be straight. Just go on an island and just die off, man, and leave the children alone. All right, now let's close up. There's madness out here, man, because there's spirits. There's evil spirits around, man. Perverted spirits. All right, let's close up. Give me Revelations. Chapter 18, Revelation 14 and 8.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 14 and verse 8.
Bring it out, King.
And there followed another angel saying, Babylon is fallen.
Babylon is what?
Babylon is fallen.
Babylon is fixed and upright.
Babylon is fallen.
Babylon is down, man.
It's fallen.
It's what?
It's fallen.
Yeah, man, that guy on his t-shirt about, I'm going to Babylon. You're going to a fallen drunken place, man. Babylon is done.
That great city.
That what?
That great city.
That damn faggot city.
Because she made all nations drunk of the wine of the rum of her fornication.
That's why he says that gay prides can't help the straight pride, man. Because it's done. Great pride has fallen, man. All right, and it ain't getting up. It's burning by thermonuclear destruction. All right? So we'll give all praises, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Ba'ashem. Yahushai, Baharakar Kadash, Kwam Yashavala, Bashama Mashiach, Yahushai,
Shama Mashiach,
Done.